Hi, I'm Adrian, R&D software engineer from Keysight Pathway Acceleration team. In this video, I will be guiding you through the basic knowledge of verdict in OpenTAP, as well as the steps to write limit handling test step. Let's get started. In OpenTAP, verdict is the description of the overall result of test step and test plan. Verdict can be set to 6 different types, according to its severity. Here we have not set, pass, inconclusive, fail, aborted, and error. At the end of each run, you could see the verdict of a test plan in the log panel. Now, I'm going to guide you on how to write the limit handling test step. Here, we have our Visual Studio with OpenTAP SDK installed. First, create a new OpenTAP plugin project. Now, we are seeing a template of test step and we could start writing our code from here. Then, we set the test step name as limit handling and the description as perform the limit handling on the value. Change the class and constructor into limit handling. Next, we declare 3 data members for users input and limits. During the run, the input value will be checked whether it is within the upper and lower limits. Let's set the input, upper, and lower limits as 1, 0, and 5 in the constructor. Now, we write the main logic for run function. If the input value is within lower and upper limit, a pass verdict will be returned. Else, a fail verdict will be returned. Upgrade verdict is a method to update verdict if the current verdict is more severe than the previous one. Lastly, we build the code and click on the editor button to see the outcome. Here, we are seeing the windows of test automation. First, we add a limit handling test step. From the test step settings, we can observe that the values for input and limits are set. This is good enough to run the test. So, now run the test. As we can see here, we get the pass verdict. Let's change the input into 8 and see what will happen. As expected, we get a fail verdict. From here, we know that the test step works properly. Isn't it simple? Let's recap. First, we learn different kind of verdict. Second, we learn how to create a limit handling test step that would produce different kind of verdict outcome. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and we will see you in the next video.